In the financially tumultuous decade, after I left my position in sales at Microsoft to run a fire protection business, I had to file for bankruptcy protection a number of times. During one such proceeding, the trustee of the loan issued a deed to the O'Neills, who recorded that deed. When my attorney contacted the attorneys for Chase Auckland, they informed him the sale was void. However, the trustee never recorded a rescission of that trustee deed. Only Chase or the trustee could do so under California law. It sat unnoticed like a time bomb. In my next case, 02-14014, attorneys for Chase Auckland persuaded the court that my TILA rescission, tendered after an accounting snafu, was made in bad faith, and convinced the court to dismiss my case with prejudice. Then, out of bankruptcy protection, I attempted to refinance with a new lender, IndyMac Bank. The property was appraised and I was approved by IndyMac, who was prevented from completing that refinance due to the title still being vested to the O'Neills. The trustee quickly held another sale and issued another deed to a real estate investor, Vista Homes. And then, 2 days after Vista won possession in their eviction trial, the loan's trustee at last recorded a rescission of the O'Neill deed. I have sought justice ever since. Justice I was seeking in my October 2nd, 2007 letter could not be dispensed by Andy North in the Cleveland office. Andy pointed out that Chase was a trustee of a trust in which my loan was but a fractional part. However, Chase was also the beneficiary of my loan or bundle of loans and a member of this gang of three. Chase Manhattan being the beneficiary of the note, Dreyfus Ryan and Wickenbach, the loan's trustee, who has since filed for bankruptcy protection, and this new player in the mortgage business, Auckland Bank, FSB, which was not a bank at all, but a loan service company, which was either grossly incompetent or criminal or both. If the beneficiary hires another company to service its loan portfolio, that's fine. That is the company's own prerogative on how best to run their operation for maximum profit. But it also must be held accountable for the damages created by that agent when its negligent or unlawful behavior damages the citizen. Not unlike the prowling lion that escapes from the traveling circus and makes the circus liable for any damage or injury caused by the roaming lion. What I requested requires an executive decision from the highest level, namely Jamie Dimon. I have included my latest legal petition that is now the subject of my appeal. This pleading will give you a general idea of what has happened to me and the issues concerning the violations of law by agents of Chase and their business partners. Although the legal issue centers on a violation of the bankruptcy court's automatic stay, the attorneys for Chase and Auckland have removed this matter from the Bankruptcy Appellate Panel, or BAP, for the Ninth Circuit to the United States District Court. This is the second time they have done this. In the spring of 2002, they removed my appeal of the judge's original ruling denying my relief from the BAP to the United States District Court. I presume there is some legal advantage for them to do so. As it now stands, it is now assigned to United States District Court, Central District of California, case number 07772GAF. The Honorable Gary A. Fees presiding. Andy Norris correctly pointed to Ocwen as ripe for inquiry, unaware that these, quote, bankers were so wily as to escape scrutiny made by Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger on my behalf in 2004. The governor contacted the Office of Thrift Supervision, who in turn contacted Ocwen, who simply lied in their response. I lost my home of 26 years, and my business ran from that home by the steamroller tactics of the legal representatives of this gang of three, and perhaps my own ineffective pro se prosecution of the case, which took me to the United States Supreme Court, who declined review, and then back to the original judge. But she has remained stubborn. The Honorable Meredith Drury, the bankruptcy judge from whose decision that I'm appealing, is also making it difficult for me to pursue this appeal by not submitting the order denying my motion. She has dragged her feet like this before. In 2005, in a case involving my personal property, the BAP, for the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals, reversed her decision on the same issues that are presented in this case. Violations of the automatic stay under then 11 U.S.C. 362. See Ozine versus Dollar Storage, January 17, 2006, the Ninth Circuit BAP. That BAP ruling gives me solid and reasonable hope that I will prevail in this case eventually. However, after watching a few videos with Jamie, I was inspired by his sense of fair play and respect for ethical behavior. And in a moment of inspiration, I decided to hold out an olive branch hope of Christian faith that this can be resolved in the High Court of Reasonable Men with Jamie Dimon presiding. That is my prayer. I added the my final argument, thanks to Paul Newman. Well, you know, much of the time, we're just lost. We say, please God, tell us what's right. Tell us what's true. And there is no justice. The rich win, the poor powerless. We become tired of hearing people lie. And after a time, we become dead. A little dead. We think of ourselves as victims. And we become victims. We become weak. We doubt ourselves. We doubt our beliefs. We doubt our institutions. And we doubt the law. But today, you're the law. You are the law. Not some book, not the lawyers, not a marble statue, the trappings of the court. See, those are symbols of our desire to be just. They are, in fact, a prayer. I mean, a fervent and a frightened prayer. In my religion, they say, act as if you had faith. Faith will be given to you. If we are to have faith in justice, we need only to believe in ourselves and act with justice. I believe we have justice in our heart. Everybody ought to be loved.